Welcome to the PLYMC's Beyond Books, where we discuss books, programs, and all things library-related in Youngstown and Mahoning County. My name is Bridget.
And I'm Sam.
And I'm Missy.
Thank you for tuning in. Today, we will be talking about our Summer Discovery Reading Program.
This year's theme is Imagine Your Story, and it's going to be different because our story is different this year, right?
I mean, in the past, it's just been going to the library and reading as many books as you can and keeping track on a log. How is it different this year?
It's going to be a lot different this year in that with the pandemic, we don't have people coming into the libraries. So this year, it's going to be just one program of summer discovery bingo. Instead of having different age groups have different programs, it's one program. And everybody's going to get a bingo card. And they'll fill in the bingo card.
And there's going to be different options. So there's going to be either reading or you can do activities. The bingo card is going to have activities such as reading and writing, STEAM, get active, community, cooking, and arts and crafts. But if you don't want to do the activities, you can do increments of 15-minute reading. So you'll just check off different boxes.
So it doesn't matter how many books you read this summer, it just matters how much time you spend reading.
Exactly.
Well, that's really cool.
You have to complete two cards. So there's one for June and one in for July. And that's how you'll get your prize.
Okay, so you mentioned we could do reading for that, reading in increments, but we also mentioned activities. Let's talk more about those. What are the activities that we can do to get credit for our bingo sheets?
So there is an activity sheet with suggestions on our website, but you can also do other activities that have to do with those different themes. So if you want to do a STEAM activity and it's not on that activity list, you can still do it. But some suggestions, what are you guys doing?
For reading and writing, I think the try reading a book from a new author is a great suggestion. I'm sure we all have new authors that we want to try. This is a good opportunity to do that.
I think so, too. And I think checking out some graphic novels. There's some blogs on our library website, by the way, on graphic novels.
You know, I just finished a great graphic novel this week. It's called They Called Us Enemy by George Takei. Have you heard of George Takei before? He was in Star Trek.
I love him. He's great.
He also spent his childhood years in forced incarceration with his family during World War II. Did you know that?
I did.
If you're a fan, you probably did. But this graphic novel is all about how he spent his childhood and how it's influenced him and how he deals with it now. I did check, and it is available in hard copy from the library, and it's also on Hoopla. If you wanted to check it out, I thought it was great. It's probably perfect for young adults. I enjoyed it a lot as an adult, and I would probably even let middle grade readers read it as well, just keeping in mind that there might be some mature content. I loved it.
Hoopla is a great resource for graphic novels, too. Stuff that we may not necessarily even have in hard copy, you can find on Hoopla, and everybody has access to it.
I like Hoopla, too, because of the audiobooks. I've been listening to those. I don't have a whole lot of time to read right now because I'm a three-month-old, but I've mostly been reading children's books to her. We have I have a bunch of books on baby animals, but Pete the Kitty, Goodnight Moon, so those are the ones I'm reading right now. So I'm not reading a whole lot of adult books.
But you could read Goodnight Moon over and over again, and every time you read it, you can count it now.
That's
absolutely
true.
Yes.
So actually, Sam, you're winning.
That, you know, that there's something for that.
That's good to keep in mind. You could probably sign up your baby daughter, too, for summer reading, right?
I can.
You don't have to be a reader yourself.
No, and you know, anytime you're reading to your kids, that counts because they're hearing it.
And if you want to get two kids involved and have the older kid read to the younger one, they could both count their time.
Mm-hmm. Or read to their stuffed animals or their
Absolutely.
Dog. Or cats, whatever animals you have, some fish. I think my niece has read to her fish before.
This is a little bit off topic, but did you see the Korean Baseball League is playing in front of stadiums full of stuffed animals?
So I saw that.
That's great. So you can do the same
adorable thing
with your summer reading. Oh, fantastic.
So the most recent book that I actually finished was I'm obsessed with mysteries now, and I didn't used to like them, and now all of a sudden I can't get enough. And I've been waiting for a long time on the hold list for the ebook of Kathy Reich's latest, A Conspiracy of Bones. So I finished it in about 2 days.
And I think it was definitely a worthwhile part of the series. If you don't read those, they're really procedural and they go through a lot of the forensics and the anthropology part of solving crimes. So it was pretty interesting. So if you like the science-y part of crime solving, these books are definitely good ones to check out.
Missy, is that the book series that the TV series Bones was based on?
Yeah, it's kind of based on it. It's real loosely. Bones was sort of like a combination of Kathy Reich's life and some of the situations from her books.
Okay.
But I loved the series Bones, like the TV series was one of my favorite TV series when it was running. And that's why I started reading the books. And I really do enjoy them. They're a lot of fun. They keep you guessing. She gets a concussion in just about every book. So I'm not sure what her eventual brain is going to look like, but
that reminds me of Korean dramas because they they get an amnesia in so many of Korean dramas. It's like,
so like soap operas then.
Yeah.
Well, it's just like whenever you have a murder mystery series that goes on too long and you're thinking, how many people live in this small town and why does it have such a high crime rate?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, there's a lot of places I'm not moving to. Like, I'm never moving to Oxford. Because according to the Inspector Morse and Inspector Lewis series, a lot of people are murdered in Oxford.
Those books don't really, you know, play up living in certain places. So
yeah, they don't really work with their local tourist councils.
No.
You have to suspend your disbelief a little bit for that, I think.
Yeah, my favorite is Louise Penny. Most of them take place in a very, very, very small village in the Montreal area. And I can't imagine how there's this many murders in this teeny tiny little village. But I'm still obsessed with the books.
Seems like it would be really easy to actually solve the problem, and it never really is.
No, and it never is. It's always someone you didn't expect.
We're talking about reading and writing activities. What about STEAM activities? Can you think of any examples?
Some of the ones that are recommended or suggested, I should say, are things like building a boat that floats or making a paper airplane, just something as simple as that, or watching a thunderstorm and writing down your observations about the thunderstorm.
And on our website, and you'll find these on our Facebook page too, but there's Lego building challenges, there's sidewalk chalk. Yeah, if you want to, there's a lot of people doing sidewalk chalk right now. It's a good one.
And check our library blogs because we do have STEAM blogs going up as well. And a lot of those will give you suggestions, maybe give you a jumping off point even for an activity that you didn't think of.
I think using the library website would be great because those would also count towards community activities, because when you participate in the library, you're participating in your community, whether you're doing one of the daily library chats on Facebook or listening to Storyline on the phone, or even just playing family game night on Fridays with the mm-hmm. librarians. Did anybody do that this week?
Family game night. I thought that was fun. there's a lot of funny answers on there too, but you know, seeing people draw live.
I thought it would be.
It was. I wasn't sure how it was going to go, but it was really fun to watch them. And I was just like, I never would have been that good of a drawer. So
when I play Pictionary with my family, somebody usually screws up so much, and everybody did a great job with the Pictionary, the librarians on Friday. So could recognize almost everything.
I also like seeing all of the daily chats on the Facebook page too. So there's always ones about books, but they're really branching out and talking about other things. And then get active activities. What are you guys doing to get active right now?
Well, I just got a Peloton delivered about a half an hour ago, so I'm very excited to use that. And also, I do yoga. I happen to live with a yoga teacher. So that has helped me a lot over the last however many weeks that we've been here. Having somebody to do yoga with and to kind of lead me in flows has been great. And we do have yoga on our library programs as well. There are virtual yoga programs that are going on.
I've seen Miss Tracy's library programs about yoga. Those are mostly for kids, but they're good for adults too, especially people like me who have not done yoga before and need to take baby steps to get into it.
Anybody can do yoga. Accessible for all ages and all fitness levels.
Well, unless you fall over when you're
just I'm don't sorry, do the I, balance.
I'm terrible with balance. I don't know.
Just don't do the balance.
Gravity is tougher on some of us than it is on others.
Balancing is just practice. That's what they always tell us in classes. It just takes practice. And I usually just modify.
And then let's see, there's some blogs about cooking. I wanted to try this fennel sausage rigatoni at some point. Oh,
That looked fabulous, yeah.
But there's all kinds of things to do. You can get ideas from our library website, on all of our blogs. So, you know, if you're looking for something to do for your bingo activities, you can always check there.
How do I sign up for this bingo, by the way?
Well, there's a couple different things you can do. You can go to our website, librarysvisit.org, and there's a link for summer discovery, and you just sign up right there. If you don't want to go to the website, you can give us a call at 330-259-3399, and we can print out a bingo card. Well, actually, we have physical ones, but we can get you a bingo card, and you can pick it up at one of our curbside locations, Austintown, Boardman, Canfield, or Maine. And there are some other locations throughout town that are stops where you can pick up bingo cards, so keep your eye out while you're on your travels. There may be some bingo cards out there.
I think they're supposed to be printed in the Vindicator and in Metro Monthly, if I'm not mistaken.
I believe they are, yes.
But if I'm not checking books out at the library, I'm doing pretty well with ebooks right now. Can I just fill out my bingo card online?
Yes, absolutely. You could do everything online. You don't have to have it printed out physically. Some people just like to have that, especially parents for kids. They like to have that visual and that tangible card for their kids to be able to show them what they're doing.
It is. I think kids are definitely more visual, and they like to be able to see that they're checking off those boxes.
Yeah, they definitely see with their hands a lot of the time.
Now, if you're finishing your challenges, one for June and one for July, so will you get a book? And there are fall celebrations coming up, hopefully. We're still working on those details, but there's going to be some for kids and teens. And anybody excited about what they're doing for adults?
Yes, I am. I think the adult program is going to be an awesome one this year.
What are they doing for adults?
Mocktails, mocktail bar.
Ooh, so is that going to take place in the library? Can I get all fancy and dress up and drink some mocktails?
Absolutely. We are hoping we are back in the library by then.
I do. Do you have a favorite mocktail? Does anybody have one?
Shirley Temple?
Yeah, I was always partial to the Shirley Temples.
I really do like how a lot of mocktails are just named after celebrities like Roy Rogers and Arnold Palmer, and it just makes them easy to associate.
What about summer performers, especially for kids? Is there anything going on like that?
We're going to be doing virtual performers this year, so you can go to our website to see those, or you can find them on links to our Facebook page. We have Professor Tony will treat viewers to a fairy tale story with magic. So LED juggling and comedy. There's Dr. Cletus Beaker and Hillbilly Silly Science. There's going to be a summer science program that you're going to be able to view online, and you can see that now. And I've watched some of it. I didn't watch the whole thing, but it was pretty cute so far. He's a little crazy. But there's also another one that you can view right now, Science Tellers, and they are currently viewing Dragons, Return of the Ice Sorceress. That can be viewed through September 1st, and that was a cute one too. Did anybody watch it?
I did watch Science Tellers, and I watched some of the Hillbilly Silly Science so far. I am still in the middle of it. And what I like about these is that they've created these science experiments that you might be able to recreate at home with an adult's help. And so, especially if you have lots of toilet paper, both of these performers love using toilet paper. And I don't know if they realize how hard it is for some of us to find nowadays, but
I've actually done the one with the leaf blower and toilet paper before. It's fun, but you have to clean up the toilet paper after. So that's not as fun.
Yeah, that's the drawback.
I imagine it would be a fun outdoor activity, but then you're going to have to explain to your neighbors why you're toilet papering your own house. But
that's true. But if you don't want to know what we're talking about, you have to go and watch the video.
Right. But it looks like we're going to have a really exciting summer discovery. So thanks to these wonderful programs and awesome performers.
Yes. And also we have to give thanks to the contributions of our generous sponsors. Our sponsors this year are Elva and Nicholas Basista, Angeline Guerreri, John and Adrian Howell, Allison Lauver, Chuck E. Cheese, Dairy Queen, Friends of the Library, Austintown, Boardman, and Poland Friends, Friends of PLYMC, Friends of PLYMC Bookstore, Mahoning Valley Scrappers Baseball, In Memory of Olga Maruskin, Raising Canes, the Rotary Club of Austintown, Boardman, Canfield, and Poland, Sam's Club and the Walmart Foundation, Youngstown State University Athletic Department, and the Youngstown Phantoms hockey team.
Thank you for joining us this month at PLYMC's Beyond Books. Make sure to visit our website at www.libraryvisit.org, where you can always find more great things the library has to offer. While you're at it, if you enjoyed this show, tell a friend. Also, check out our Instagram feed or follow us on Facebook at Library Mahoning County, or find us on Twitter or YouTube at PLYMC. Be sure to tune in for our next episode. Thanks for listening.